from the industry. Lakshmi Padilegi is a past president of TICO, and today's keynote speaker Mohan Krishna, the founder CEO of IT Prof, and my colleague Vamsi Krishna Raila, the CEO of Rusa project. The invitees, experts from industry, students, IT professionals, and all the students from engineering college as well as MBA and other colleges, and ladies and gentlemen. So I welcome all of you for this today's workshop on Industry 4.0 and also the interaction of students with industry. Once we name Industry 4.0, many things will come into picture. Automation is the biggest one we are talking about today. So all the automation is related with Industry 4.0. And you are talking about artificial intelligence, machine learning, IoT, networking, and all those things are basically a part of Industry 4.0. So from a system of manufacturing to an automation, in between you are losing the man and machines, but the technology is coming. That is one of the key points what we are understanding, how to cope up with this technology. The other point what I would like to see from the program is the technology transfer and industry collaboration and placements, entrepreneurship and startups ecosystem in the university. Now when you look up the total scenario in the university system, and I don't know the scenario on the outside also, fortunately, unfortunately, the whole system is moving out towards IT only. Computer science, computer science, computer science. One branch, second branch, third branch. Many engineering colleges, they are no takers for the core courses like ECE, EEE, civil, mechanical and all those things. So there is a need to shift from our understanding of the core subjects to the application point of view. I'm not saying that we should not understand core subject, but somehow we are led to the system where we are driven towards the IT, computer science and other things. When you talk about the companies, most of the companies are here. I welcome all of you, sir. The thing what we are seeing is there is a lot of increase in the number of IT companies. There is no much balance when you compare to the other companies, to the IT companies. So the professionals, we are going towards the IT professional, we are going towards automation, we are going towards artificial intelligence. But when you see the situation in the academia, we are not moving much faster. If industry is going like a Vande Bharat train, academia is going like a passenger train. That is a problem what we are facing. Industry is much faster, but we are not able to catch up the industry requirements and demands. So the students, our curriculum also has to be revised. And unfortunately now, the curriculum or education system, I always get a doubt. Is our education system is a knowledge-based platform or economy-based platform? Now people are not asking how much knowledge you got. People are asking how much package you are getting. That is the situation we are going now. How much of K, 90K or 100K or what is your package? So there is always a need to balance the two systems now. We need not sacrifice our core subjects. We need not sacrifice our fundamentals. We need not sacrifice the other disciplines. But of course, we need to catch up with the Industry 4.0 also. So this is a platform where the industry professionals will talk to you the readiness of the student. Because once you complete your BTEC or go to your MBA degree and other things, is you are ready for the industry requirement? That is the question they are asking. Many companies, when we talk to them, they say that, sir, we don't have any time to give a training and take a student. We cannot spend 6 months or 1 year and a graduate giving a training to do our requirements. So they want a ready-made solution. They want the graduate to come and immediately take up the job and deliver the goods. So to that extent we had to go now. That's one important point. So the students here, you have to see what are the job opportunities, how the things are improving. Based on that, how do you acquire your skill base? That is the focus of today's discussion, I understand. And with these people sitting here, industry people, sir, we look at you to give us some scope of improving our curriculum, where we can start few courses on industry-based orientation. It is not purely academia-centric courses, but few courses where there is a job employment is there, we can plan, the university is ready, our administration is very positive, we are ready to adopt few courses. Recently we have started MS in data science. Similarly, we are also planning for a course on virtual production. So similarly, any other ideas are there, any course which you think is useful to the students, we are ready to adopt that. And the technology transfer is one last point I would touch, because I don't know it is an outbound transfer or inbound transfer. So from academia to industry or industry to academia, these two things we have to discuss, because to make a startups here, to create an ecosystem, our technology transfer may not be sufficient. So I request you to make an inbound technology transfer things and then help the university in getting this ecosystem, employment and industry connect to the curriculum. So with this small note, I welcome all of you for this meeting. Thank you one and all for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much.